my feet, then I pump fake. Baby girl, grab the crew. What if kiss it? Sway Lee, Mr. Couldn't have took it quicker. Hottest on the planet, got the place lit up. Fly tribe, got expensive taste, sight into it. We ain't on the same team, cheer up. Bunch of put that make sit up. I ain't come to blend in, boy, I stand out. Money talks, you just popping off at the mouth. If I'm the topic, then the conversation heated. Ray Shrimp, getting booked up in every city. Splash up with cash, had the spaz on the waiter. She messed up my times in a row.
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. Game time getting close, and for this guy, he's hoping for the same result they came away with last week. That was a win for them, and the touchdown he scored on the ground was a big help to their cause. It's the Bengals going up against the Patriots. So let's get you up to Foxborough as we check in with our commentators, Brandon Godden and James Davis.
All right, Larry, thanks. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. Today, we've got a Week 6 matchup for you here between the Cincinnati Bengals and the New England Patriots. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaudin. And Charles, we look at this Patriots team entering play. They were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week,
now it's Nugent out to kick it away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 yards with a new rule as he's taken down right at the 20-yard line. So here come the Patriots now to take over on offense. They're led out by a guy who's done just about everything you could ever imagine to do in this league, the great Tom Brady.
It's been a lot of fun watching him develop in his career, but that will to win, he's had that probably since birth, and it transmits itself throughout his entire ball club. Watching him play, it can be an absolute joy unless you're on the other team.
Brady now on first down. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he's brought down. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
A carry heading left, and very little room to maneuver. They'll get this down to about the 39. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. Let's discuss this offense now, and Julian Edelman, very good player.
Has really developed into a terrific slot receiver, and a lot of times he would be the primary receiver. Still mad, coming out of college, that he's not a quarterback in the NFL. He takes it out on the opposing defenses.
As we hit the midway point of this first quarter. Now Brady throwing on second down. The throw complete to Hogan. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line.
And decided to run a hitch route. It really helps to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
First and 10, here's Brady. And he just gets rid of it. Throw. A wise move there. Open, now second down. And the Bengals starting defensive unit now.
Dansby is a comfortable at either outside or inside, and always a respected team leader.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10.
On that play, it was...
So on fourth down, on comes the left-footed punter, Kevin Huber, to play. This will be fielded at the 17. A great return there of 22 yards. And the Patriots take over. So the Patriots coming out now. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up. But you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over,
I guess. You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving it, giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away. And there's a sudden change after a turnover. Wow, now we got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Brady to throw on second down. Over the middle, that's caught by Hogan. And he's brought down. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Now a play fake here on first down. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
You ever notice that when Tom Brady does get hit and dropped to the ground, there's some guys back to him pretty quickly to check on his health, aren't there?
That's exactly right. For as much as he throws, doesn't take a lot of square shots, but took one there.
He's really smart in the pocket, isn't he? Even out of the pocket, he understands where the pressure's coming from. He senses people. You're exactly right. Doesn't take too many direct ones, but that one had to hurt.
Wait, 20!
Brady again here on second and 10. And he's got Edelman for the first time. That's complete. And he's brought down. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. The former seventh-round pick, Julian Edelman, just continues to have such a productive career.
And has made himself into a receiver. Remember, he was a college quarterback, and not just a productive one, a very good one.
At Kent State, right?
Yes, a great leader, a guy who can make plays with his feet and his arm. Got to the NFL and had to convert into being a receiver. Was drafted that way, and that conversion, oh boy, it's been good.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. In trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
So just a lone field goal in this first quarter of play. It's a three-point game here early, and we'll return to Foxborough after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Head & Shoulders. Shoulders were made for greatness, not dandruff.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number two. They've got it second and 10 to start things out. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. Give him four on the ground there. They're now left with third and six.
Well, so far, this game has gone the way the defensive coordinator had hoped. They've dictated things, and they've not let them run the ball very well at all. They gave up a nice game there. I doubt it'll back off their confidence. They've played so well throughout this entire game.
They got to get it to the 21 here on third down. They slot Gronkowski outright. Throwing is Brady on third down. He's got time in the pocket. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up four. Now it's Nugent out to kick it away. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. A strong running. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field. And says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes after saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks, because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did. And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
See if they stay on the ground for second down.
55!
From midfield, here's Brady. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. A big play, Brady to Gronkowski, 48 yards.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there? Yeah. Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Well, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he gunned down a few guys?
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
So now it's first and goal. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get him in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
Easy.
Second and goal as the offense looks to try to punch it in. And he's over the line and into the end zone for a Patriots score. A great effort there. Hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Patriots add on to their lead. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep to your sign. Here's Kevin Huber now. On for his second punt, he'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. That's taken on the 25.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker, defense.
Oh, and you just can't do that. 15 yards on the roughing the kicker call.
Absolutely inexcusable. The kicker's in a defenseless position.
Here's Kevin Huber now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And now a high kick here as he'll try to hang it up there. Fair catch called for and taken right near the 30-yard line. It'll go as just a 15-yard punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And now out come the Patriots. And that... attack here, and unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down?
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. And a nickel look here for the Bengals as they try to defend this on third. Brady going to try and throw on third down. He's got time. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. A pickup of 5 that time and a first down. Ah, yes, Brady to Gronk. You think these two are in sync?
Without a doubt. And look, they both understand what they can do for each other. Gronk knows if he gets open, the ball's going to be there. And Tom Brady knows what a great security blanket Gronk is. When all else fails, you find big 87.
Easy.
Brady now on first down. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he takes it past the 45 and down at the 46. Call it a gain of 4, and it'll leave him with a third down and 6 to go.
It's been a struggle this entire game trying to move the ball on the ground. But every now and then, you find a little chink in the armor, and that type of run right there lets them know that they can't stop every single run for almost no gain.
They slot Gronkowski outright. Brady gonna throw. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. Here's Kevin Huber now, as he's on to punt for Cincinnati.
Let's go, let's go, let's go, guys.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. That's pulled in at the 32. Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And this offense will take over right at the midfield stripe with a first and 10. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got Rome. And he cuts it out to the... There he goes, right side. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. A great play there with touchdown number 2 in the game and now 11 on the year. And the Patriots add 6 to their lead. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have...
Here's Kevin Huber now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. Taken from just outside the 30. They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and out will come the offense as they take over. Getting set to go again as we look at the back heading onto the field again. And he's found the end zone twice, and now I'm guessing he's thinking, hey, let's find it 3 times.
And you got to figure from the defensive perspective, how has he gotten there twice? What are we going to do to keep him out for a 3rd time? How do we tighten things down? Because he and his offensive mates, they are really in sync right now.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Brady now on first down. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Second down following the incompletion. Brady to throw on second down. Complete to Washington. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
A nickel back added defensively as they look to stop this 3rd and 8. From the gun, it's Brady. And he'll have his man. That's Edelman. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
I don't care how many times we see it. I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. That's going to go as a loss of 2. So both teams have marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys. But be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Geno Atkins, the Pro Bowler, in there on the stop.
In my book, that's running the ball well, but with intelligence. How about him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds?
Yeah, even though it's the 3rd quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where your running game can really help you with a lead in the second half.
I agree totally. It's not just end of the half situations that you worry about the clock. It's throughout the game. And with a lead, stay in bounds. Make them fight harder to try and catch you.
It's a gain of 7, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down. So, 2nd.
Right there. Right,
And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. Give him 3 yards there as that'll take us to fourth down. After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. And we have seen a decline in the numbers. Where does the fault lie? Just him? Maybe the guys up front? Combination?
Well, as you and I both know, it's almost always a collective deal. But in this case, I think maybe the offensive line got a little overconfident. They had blocked so well in the first half, picked up on what the defense was doing. I think we've seen an adjustment now that they have not picked up on, and now they're being a little bit overwhelmed.
And over the middle to the tight end, Bennett. Give him 3 on the play, and it'll make it second down. Well, we know he's had a lot of good games in this league. He had another good one last week, but here, he's just off, isn't he?
And that's hard to believe because we're so used to him being so good. But guess what? Even the best players are allowed to have some bad moments and stretches along the way. Normally what we see, though, is him finding a way out, finding a way to make some big-time plays before it's over. We'll see if he's able to do that in this game.
Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. They control the clock, they control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
Now Brady. And he will be hit from behind and run over. Wow. The 4-time Pro Bowler, 2-time All-Pro, Geno Atkins, able to get it. Here's Kevin Huber now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Give them a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of 2, and that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8.
But he was stopped on that play. But he's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
And on 3rd down, a nickel formation here defensively. They slot Gronkowski outright. Throwing is Brady on 3rd down. Oh, he can't get away, and Brady will go down. Carlos Dunlap in there to drop him for a loss of 10. Go with a running back, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on 1st down.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Down, here's Brady throwing into traffic there, and that's complete. 4 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it 3rd and 1.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
Yeah, another good run there. He's been such a big part of their success here this afternoon. And that last carry, it puts him over 100 yards now for the day.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. They come up in an offset eye. Brady now on first down. To the left side and complete for Julian Edelman. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible. Hope he's got man-to-man coverage and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
Short pickup there, down to about the 9. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
We have played 3 quarters. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Foxborough. We get set for the 4th quarter. Patriots have the lead. They also have the football. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. And they'll run it here. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead them to 3rd down. The 4th quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
From the gun on 3rd down, Brady. That's caught at the 1. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Rob Gronkowski, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Patriots add on to their lead. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position.
Here's Kevin Huber now, as they're forced to kick for the 6th time today. He'll get off a fairly short kick here as this is toward the sideline. And this punt goes out of bounds and it'll be marked inside the 40.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker, defense.
Oh, and you just can't do that. 15 yards on the roughing the kicker call.
Absolutely inexcusable.
Right.
They come out here in the eye. And they'll go on the ground. And he'll get down to about the 26-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two. Well, they'll take that every time with a lead, first down, fourth quarter, getting 8 yards. You love that.
They will take it, and you have to ask the defensive guys, why did you give it? I mean, you know the situation. You're down, have to stop them, have to get the football back. But 8 yards on first down puts them back on their heels.
Now Brady throwing on second down. The throw left side complete to Hogan. Only three there on the pickup. And then it's enough to move the chains. They come out here in the eye. They go play action here on first down, surveying the field. He couldn't quite hold it, got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Today's a
take this one down near the 15. 3 yards won't be enough here, as that'll bring up fourth down.
But forget knowing where the first down line was.
Here's Kevin Huber now, as he's on to punt for Cincinnati.
Let's go, let's go, let's go, guys.
And we'll see what he can do on the return. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yep. Run what
put
you
your
do
foot
best.
On the gas.
Exactly. Put it all the way down and try and increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it? Touchdowns.
It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
When a coaching staff sees their team run the ball this successfully in the fourth quarter, they're really excited, because you can plan for a running game all you want and want to press that advantage when you get it, but for the most part, it's a little bit of a surprise. And right now, they've got to keep that going, want to continue to grind out the clock, because it's definitely in their favor at this stage of the game. Can they close the game out and continue to do exactly what we just saw there, and that's run the football?
And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
Brady to throw on second down. And right side caught Hogan. It'll be a gain of four. And they're going to be... Here's Kevin Huber now, as he's on to punt for Cincinnati.
Let's go, let's go, let's go, guys.
Fielded just inside the 20. 35 yards that time on the punt, and the Patriots take over. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up, because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
On play action, it's Brady. And open here is Hogan. He's got it. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves his sticks. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course. You got to keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
We got four. We got four.
Luke 20. Wide 20.
Now a first carry for LeGarrette Blount. And he's going to take this one down to about the 46-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
That was a good, strong run there. And while it won't pick up a first down, it was definitely something needed by that offense. A positive run. They got a good push by their guys up front. Maybe something they can build on as this game continues.
They come out here in the eye.
Goal 50.
On second down, here's Brady. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big-time run, big-time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Calling a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
And he continues to pile up the yardage. That puts him over 150 now. And this defense has really had its problems trying to keep him contained.
Downfield, the big tackle gets him for a loss of 11. Second down sack by the defense. What type of pressure will they bring here on third? We'll see. Brady now to throw. Deep drop. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he's brought down after a good game. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
Going to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Time for a break. This one, all over but the shouting. We'll finish it after this. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away. 6 yards here to go for the offense on second down. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of two, now third down.
Well, Brandon, he's had a great day, and sometimes that just happens. It is the NFL. They will make some plays against you.
Out of the huddle now for play number 9 on this drive. This is third down at 8. Throwing is Brady on third down. Can't find anyone open. And almost intercepted. Would have been a huge pick in the end zone, but as it stands, that brings up... They'll give it to him right up the gut. Muscles him off. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds.
There's so many definitions of a complete back. I think most people think a guy who can block, a guy who can catch, and a guy who can run. But how about when you put it all together as a runner and you can fake people out, you can be shifty, and also run with some power and break tackles, as we just saw on that pickup.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down.